Hey guys, it's Matt again from Real Clean Service Center. Today we're going to go over some basics of the Penn International. I've got to equip this one. Don't have much time, it's going to take a while. So let's get right into it. First, we're going to remove the lock plate. Lock plate includes one screw, flathead screw, usually flathead. Lock plate there. Next, we're going to be needing a Penn standard wrench. Right there, free. You can use pliers, wrench. I really don't recommend it. I strongly recommend you get a wrench. They make models that come with a wrench at the end of it, but they're all made by Penn. You can get one for $5 on Amazon for this. Take the handle off, the other screw here. Here's the handle, comes the washer. Now we can loosen this top plate that holds houses our prison house. Make sure you're free spool. Get screws out from your top plate. Top plate runs like so. Make sure you keep everything contained. There's your drag lever. Finally, quick, you guys, I apologize. Drag quadrant plate comes off just like that. Very simple. Next, we're going to remove our drag bar, or drag slider bar, we're going to call it the pepper move, and I'm going to control. Underneath these two side screws, we're going to be spacers also. By the way, this is the Penn International 30, this is one of the first models. Keep in mind that screws are going to get light, so make sure you get everything out of it. It's only International 30, actually, I think it's around 30 years old, actually. Here's those two spacers. Sorry, there you go, two spacers. That's what we got here. Next, we're going to go around, there's five more screws, actually six more screws have to be removed, and I'm just not going to worry about anything else in here, so it's out of it. Remove the screws. Some corrosion, dust cracking off. I'm going to leave screws in your holes, and I'm going to place this side off, just like that. And then, up underneath, careful, I've got the screws, we got our main drive gear. And the main bearing comes in, that came off the top of the shaft. Notice how the inside of this is greased, coated with grease. When I rebuilt this reel last week, that's what I did. Your bearings are gonna come off also, just don't lose your stuff, guys. I can't stress enough. Leave the screws inside, like I had if you have to, but I'm actually going to take them out now. Notice all different lengths, so be careful. In order to remove this main gear, you have to undo the retainer washer that goes on top of it. I'm gonna do that now to show you how it's done. Don't you love high-speed screwdrivers, drills in this case. Take three screws out, and then, that's not the word. This pin has come out. I'll push it out, it should come the other way. That washer should come off of there. But the pin comes out, attached to your handle, there's your main gear. Inside, you just need to clean thoroughly all down that rivet, clean all this, and then put grease on it. That's what I would recommend you do. Just grease the inside, coat it. You can run all around the grease in here, and the walls. Clean on that screen where the buttons are located. As you can see, this one's pretty good, so I just got done doing it. One of those locked up on the slug. There's your main bearing. Don't let grease in there. These are not grease, these are actually, they're point coated. They're not grease pad bearings, so they just work better, but they're very smooth. Made USA, big bearings. They're probably last forever for life, this reel. For my life, tack it back. Now you have a flip plate. So I'm not going to do anything down here, but real complicated. The plate comes off, there's nothing under it. You just clean up underneath it, that's just holding on and replace it. But your shaft can't come out now. There's your shaft. It's the main shaft. Remember the lower thread down the bottom. You have several washers here. They go concave, concave. It's not really one of the spaces really to keep the shaft off that bearing. Let me zoom in here. There's another bearing there, you can take that out. This just needs to be coated with grease again, just a light coating. It's a grease, that's all it needs to be done to that. Nothing more, nothing less, you just coat the outside here. You can coat the race tracks if you want, speedways, whatever you want to call them. Some people say it's cause resistance will slow down, but guys, you're not going to be casting this thing off of here. You're not going to be casting it off of here. It's not going to be casting. A lot of these don't have to be completely free, like the big caster will be. Now you pull the spool up, all you do is get out, pull straight up. Hang out of here. Now inside this compartment is your drag washer. I may not show you what inside this because it's difficult to get apart, but I will. I'm going to do it. Why not? There are three tabs. There's a tab here, a tab there, and a tab there. You have to bend it and get it out. As you can see, this will take it apart. It's my wear. This will take it apart a few times throughout the case. I'm going to take it apart once. Just to rebuild it. So you can do that. Just press it in, kind of pull up on it. The same thing to me. Next time, be careful not to bend this cap. There it is. It comes up like that, just a ring. Then you have your main drag plate with my rubs up against. And guys, this is one of the old-time asbestos washers. Did you get this with the new dirt drag dresses that the pen was out now? You have to replace the drag pan, replace the plate in here. The shaft is also different because the gear is built into this housing. So you have to replace the shaft. It's about $90 to replace this whole tiny drag system. But you know what? This one works. It's a good shape with the vision I got. I'm not going to spend $90 if you sold this ring for $75. So this particular job, I'm going to recommend that you consider changing drag. It's a dry drag system. No grease, no oil. If you do, it will slip and you will ruin this drag system. Make sure your drag washer is centered. Put this back on top, like so. Get the cap. Now, you've got to press this in. Press against that spring. Push this cap in, or down, I should say, and then in, into its retaining room in there. Then do the same thing with this one. Push it in and down. This is a pain in the tail kind of job. I try to do it quickly because I don't have to think about it. So, once we're in, clean up here, starting on the grease. Cool thing to do, get some grease like this. When the inside is here, so when that shaft is pushing it through, that gear chamber, I should say, it will slide easier. Remember, there's a bearing there, don't keep the bearing. Wipe off the excess grease here. Okay, guys, so we were going for this international year, and we're about ready to get the point where we can put it back together. A couple things I had to fire down, besides this gear here, there were pieces of metal hanging off. We're going to have more. I don't think you can do this point before you put it back together, that we'll ensure the lifespan is real, and that's to clean out the inside here. And I'm just going to clean out a little bit to show you. All I'm going to do is wipe it out. And I'm going to do this all around, normally. Just wipe down the grease. You can put any grease right in there if you're confident about it. You're just going to get some grease like this. And what I do, I just rub it right in there. So the next thing you can do when you are putting this room back together, after you put a nice little coating of grease in there, you're going to prepare the spool. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little bit of grease in here. This is where your anti-reverse contacts these little divots inside. So that's probably aligned. You're ready to reassemble this reel. Now we're going to do it. From here, it's really easy to clean your spool. We can start with this piece. And remember, this little nub is going to go inside the bearing. And you make sure that your anti-reverse pins in here are lined up on top of the springs. They are. This one line up. You go inside there. The next thing we put in is our shaft. This is the shaft here. Do the shaft, all you gotta do is make sure there's plenty of grease on the teeth, and there's enough grease to allow the shaft to slide through the bearings pretty easy on the mid part, and more grease on our end here for it. So this shaft here is simply the thin part, goes through this top bearing, and there we go, into the hole that gets in the bottom of the spool that has teeth around the compartment. Next, we wanna focus on the inside of the side plate here, laddering zone here. But at the same time, you don't want so much that we're just gonna get away. This gear's gonna fit into this compartment there, just like that. So it's gonna fit down in here, just like this. Really, that's everything. So now we're going to get our main part here. And this is very important, so pay attention. You'll notice we have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, and then two close together, two close together. I'm gonna put our anchor in there also. Now I'm just gonna flip this over perfectly. Match up the shaft that goes through the spool with the bearings on this side, and then our gear here should match up the thing here. It does. Okay, so once you have your side plate down up here, you have just right. I'll show you the configuration of the screws. We have three short screws, we have three long screws. Now, these three screws have the wider heads, go to hold the plate on for the preset. The short screws go with three holes to match up to the real foot. Okay, the long screws will go in just like that. Okay, now the only screw left is this one here, into the post. So you have this one here, and this one here, into this post. Remember, they're reserved for your drag rail. So the only one left is this one here. Then you have to use the front two for the anchor, the back three for the real foot, and the one on the right side you have to anchor facing you for the ones that you have to worry about. Very nice. A little bit of grease underneath the drag preset. And then we're going to put the plate on. First of all, our drag lever. Remember, I said free spool. So it's going to be back on free spool. Just like that. And we're going to line up our preset knob. So I'm going to do it. We're on. And remember, we had these three screws. Hold it in. And all the same, we have wider heads than the others. All right. Very nice. And the last thing we're gonna do before we put on our handle, we're gonna put on our drag lever rail. And I always start by putting this center piece, you see, start with my finger. And that seems to hold on pretty good. So now you can look around whatever you want. These little spacers, you have to be careful of. To get my measures right, I sometimes will use tweezers. Some people I shake hands, I don't, but that kind of helps with people who I shake hands. You can set it in there, just like that. Pretty simple. Now, you got two screws that hold in your drag rail. One is short, one is very long. The way to remember this, you're screwing directly into the frame here. You're not screwing into a post. And so, if you think about it, this one's way too long, screwing in that frame. So you're straight through, see? So you're straight through the frame, and so this one goes on the side, we're screwing into your post, and now we can play a space for it. That's the way to remember that. Okay, now the middle screw. Be careful with this one, I'm going to strip out, so I'll put the weight too tight. And the last one goes in the frame. The last thing we need to do in this wheel, is the handle back on. First you have your washer that goes on here, and you have your handle. Which, remember, it always helps to have a Penn standard wrench for these nuts, for these bolts. You're just going to twist it around just like so. You don't need that lock to take it work. You have to fit the middle or the valley between two teeth to line up with that hole. That's a pretty tight fit, but I have. But they say it all do it just fine. Press hard enough. That works just fine. Now that's just going to adjust, right? And it does. And now you can always tell, if you do mess something up, it'll mess the whole wheel up. It'll run all off. But we have a free spool. We're going to drag up. We're going to put right straight. We should have around at least 10 pounds of drag. That's right. We have a free spool. It's good enough. This one, I can't even try it. And it spins just fine. Another thing is clicker, and then you get all through it all done, you can get some WD-40, and spray on this rag here, and just go through, and just wipe it all off. That's how you take the apart, that's how you service on it, any parts you need to replace it through what I explain, you can get to them, what it is made. Hey guys, this has been a production by the Real Clean Service Center. My name is Matt. You can go to my website, www.realcleanservices.com, that's part E-L. And that's where you find all information about services, pricing, location, contact information, as well as my Facebook page, which you can go and like if you like. Appreciate you watching, have a good day, and bye.